Is there like one activity or a small number of activities that you'd suggest to me that would be most valuable?
Sure. I'd say, I guess the first thing that comes to mind is just a spin on the old favorite of the minute paper. I think, you know, given the definition that I just gave for reflection, I think a lot of people recognize that many active learning or even classroom assessment techniques, a lot of these practices are related, if not, you know, fitting pretty cleanly underneath the umbrella of reflection as we've defined it. With the minute paper, for example, at the end of your class, having students think about what they've done, what they've learned, and writing something down to some significant nugget of learning that they picked up. Now, that has, as I've described it so far, that already has two of the ingredients. The prior experience is just that, whatever, 50 minutes or whatever that you just spent in class. You're looking back on it, and maybe what you want to do is, as an educator, you might prompt your students to focus on a certain aspect of the class period. So perhaps the most obvious would just be something interesting that you've learned, but maybe you could put a twist on it, like, is there something, is there some topic that you're worried about, right? Some topic that you covered today, or something that happened in class today that you've been concerned about. And that puts a particular lens on that experience. And then perhaps you could augment the minute paper and build the second minute. I'm glad you said two instead of one, because I don't know what I would do if I didn't have that extra minute. You could have a follow-up question that says, well, what are you going to do about that? Now that you identified something that you're concerned about, how might you follow up as a student to address that concern? And it might be, it might be a class activity, an in-class activity that kind of went badly or uncomfortably, so maybe the follow-up that the student might suggest to themselves is, well, maybe I should just talk to the peers that I was working with. It might be some in-class exercise that was really, really confusing, or a proof or something that just didn't make sense to them, so that might mean visiting office hours or checking with the instructor right after the class. And, you know, that's a really small, kind of like a nanoscale reflection, but we do think that's a perfectly reasonable instance of reflection, and one that hopefully somebody could fit in to pretty much any class setting, regardless of the stress that they're looking at.